Well, hello and good morning, students. I am your bio teacher Vikas sir from Eklavya Educational Complex. My dear students, I hope that you all are staying cool and fine at your home. And yes, you are also following very strictly this COVID protocol. That means you have to wear the mask, sanitize your thing frequently, regularly wash your hand, don't step out your feet from your home, eat the food which is being cooked in your home. So these are the some COVID appropriate behavior you have to strictly follow this. And if you are not following this, means who will face the consequences? You only. So you have to strictly follow this COVID appropriate behavior. My dear students, today we are going to study the another life processes, that is transportation. So why this transportation is necessary for the living organism? If this transportation is not happening in the living organism, what will happen? So beginning of this topic with this question is really amazing. And if we are thinking upon these questions, means this topic becomes so much easier. So in last two videos or in previous videos, we have studied about nutrition, we have studied about digestion, and we have studied about respiration. So every life processes have their own importance. Likewise, this transportation have their own impact in field of metabolic reactions. So starting with the definition of transportation, what is transportation? So my dear students, it is a life process in which movement of substance from one part of the body to the another part, if it takes place from one part of the body to the another part, so this movement of substance is known as what? Transportation. And yes, my dear students, this transportation process is very much important. Why it is important? We are going to study. Transportation helps in the supply of food materials from our different body parts. It also carry oxygen, water and useful chemicals like hormones, as well as it also collect waste material from all over our body cells. So these many are the importance of transportation that we have studied, that we study right now. Now based on our syllabus, this transportation topic is being divided into two parts. First one that we are going to study right now, that is transportation in plants as well as transportation in animals. So one by one we are going to study this separately, transportation in plants as well as transportation in animals. So first one, we are going to study about the transportation in plants. So the substance which are transported in plants are water, minerals and prepared food. So the plants have two type of transporting tissue, which is also known as vascular tissue or conducting tissue, that is xylem and phloem. This xylem carries water and phloem carry prepared food from leaf to different parts of the body. And we have already studied in the photosynthesis topic that photosynthesis takes place in the leaf of the plant. After dark reaction, carbon dioxide reduced into glucose, and this will takes place in the leaf of this plant. So from there, food is being transported to the different body parts of the plant through phloem. And xylem carry water and minerals. After absorption of root, this xylem helps in the transportation of water and minerals to the different parts of the plant. So basically, these two tissue, that is xylem and phloem, are responsible for conduction of water and food in plants. So I think this topic is very much clear to everyone, that which type of substance are being conducted inside the plant body. Now our next topic is, we are going to study in detail how this transportation processes takes place, how this transportation processes takes place in plants with the help of these two vascular tissue, that is xylem and phloem. So one by one we are going to study how the conduction of water takes place and how the transportation of food takes place in plants. My dear students, water and minerals are absorbed from the soil by the roots of the plant. Here in this image you can see very clearly that water are being absorbed by the roots of the plant from the soil. Now after that, it moves through the root to the different body parts of the plant by xylem. And in standard 9, that means in previous class, I already teach you about the detailed structure of xylem and phloem. Actually, xylem is a tissue, and what is tissue? Means group of cells. So this xylem tissue is also made up of four different cells: xylem vessels, xylem tracheids, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fiber. Except xylem parenchyma, these three tissue, xylem vessels, tracheids, and fiber, are non-living cells, and xylem parenchyma are the only living constituent cells inside this xylem. And basically, xylem tracheids and xylem vessels are responsible for conduction of water inside this plant. Means after absorption of water and minerals by the roots of the plant from this soil, this xylem vessels and xylem tracheids, which is the constituent cell of this xylem, it helps in the conduction of water and minerals in upward direction, or in unidirectional way. And in such a way, conduction of water and minerals takes place in plants with the help of this xylem tissue. And especially inside xylem tissue, xylem vessels and xylem tracheids is responsible. So here, water and minerals together, it is known as sap. together it is known as sap, because water are mixed with minerals also, and this minerals is essential for the growth of the plants. So water along with this mineral is known as sap. So conduction of sap takes place inside the plant with the help of xylem tracheids and xylem vessels, which is the constituent cell material or the cell of this xylem tissue. So in such a way, conduction of water, or we can say it as sap, takes place inside this plant. Now my dear student, our second topic is what? Conduction of food or transportation of food. So we already know that the food manufacturing or the food is being manufactured in the leaf of the plant after photosynthesis. We have already studied detail about this photosynthesis, how leaf of the plant means the presence of chlorophyll in the leaf absorbs sunlight. After that, splitting of water takes place, ATP formation takes place, NADP is reduced into NADPH2, and how this ATP and NADP is being utilized in the dark reaction to reduce the carbon dioxide into glucose, that is known as Kelvin-Benson cycle. And after all these processes, after all this reaction of this photosynthesis, formation of glucose takes place inside the leaf of the plant. So the food is being manufactured in the leaf of the plant. So if it is already kept there, means that is not enough for the plant for their metabolic reaction. So that food have to be transported to the different body parts of this plant, so that each and every body parts get this food and utilize it in their metabolic reaction. So how this food is transported to the different body parts of the plant, that is the main thing, and that is the main processes. So transportation, the word transportation makes this manufactured food easier to reach to each and every body part of this plant. And with the help of phloem tissue, this transportation of food becomes easier. And phloem is responsible for transportation of this food materials in each and every body part of the cell. My dear student, when I am talking about phloem tissue, so phloem is also a type of tissue. And what is tissue means? Group of cells combined together to form tissue. So this phloem tissue is also made up of four different cells, that is sieve tube, companion cell, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fiber. Except phloem fiber, all these three cells, that is sieve tube, companion cells, and phloem parenchyma, are living cells, and this phloem fiber are non-living cells. So basically here, sieve tube is responsible for conduction of food from leaf to different body parts of the plant. That means conduction of food takes place in multi-direction way, but conduction of water takes place in unidirectional way, always in upward direction. So phloem टिश्यू इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कंडक्शन ऑफ फूड मटेरियल एंड स्पेशली इन फ्लोएम टिश्यू सीव ट्यूब इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कंडक्शन ऑफ फूड मटेरियल फ्रॉम लीफ टू डिफरेंट बॉडी पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट एंड दिस कंडक्शन ऑफ फूड बाय द हेल्प ऑफ फ्लोएम टिश्यू स्पेशली सीव ट्यूब इज नोन एज ट्रांसलोकेशन इज नोन एज ट्रांसलोकेशन. So that's all in this video about how transportation of plants, how transportation of food and water takes place inside the plants. My dear students, once again I am going to recap all these things. So we have studied about what is transportation, what is the need of transportation, what are the different substances that are being transported in this plant, and how the transportation of water and food takes place inside the plants. So that's all about in this video, and few of the questions I am giving you in the form of your assignment, and you have to solve it. So the questions are: define transportation. First question is define transportation. Second question: how transportation is important in all the living organisms. The third question is what is the need of transportation. Question number 4: what are the different substances that are being transported in the plants. Question number 5 is what are the different tissue which is responsible for transportation of food and water inside the plants. And question number 6: explain in detail about the transportation of food and transportation of water inside this plant. So that's all for today's video classes, my dear students. We shall meet on the next video classes as well as in next live classes. So I just hope that you all are enjoying this online learning session, and along with your study you have to strictly follow this COVID protocol. That is my heartiest appeal to everyone. Thank you, my dear students. Just take care of